when you understand, when you seek for me and you find me, when you search for me with all your heart, I will be found by you, says the Lord, and I will bring you back from your captivity. He said, I will gather you from all the nations and from all the places where I have driven you, says the Lord, and I will bring you to a place from which I call to be carried away captive. See, he will bring you into a place of freedom where you won't be captive in yourself. See, I want to go through, write down Matthew 1. See, when you go down Matthew 1, I'm gonna go quick with this, because when you look at Matthew 1, let's look at verse 18. When you look at verse 18, this is talking about the birth of Jesus. Now, the birth of Jesus was as follows. When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, behold, they came together, and she was found to be with child by the Holy Spirit. Say, unorthodox. So you got to understand, when God birthed something in you, it got to be orthodox. This woman was pregnant, come on here, and no man had touched her. She was 16 years old. Come on here. Never been touched by a man. And she was supposed to engage to Joseph. And he is saying, I ain't finna marry her. I ain't touch her because she ain't no virgin. Come on here. And so the angel of the Lord had to tell him that she was pregnant with child. Why are you saying that? Because God want to use you, knowing that you've been molested, knowing that you've been talked about, knowing you've been on drugs, you've been a prostitute. Come on here, you've been a lesbian, you've been a homosexual. Come on, you've been a liar, you've been a thief. And God still got a purpose for your life, because he want to let you know, I knew you when you were in your mother's womb. I knew you. But I still chose you, because I got a purpose for your life. So you don't have to walk around talking about I ain't good enough. You don't have to walk around talking about people looking at me. No, I'm going to go around and tell them I used to be a whore, because I got anointing that would draw out other whores. He began to tell, I want to go ahead of myself. See, I want to show you the pattern of Jesus, and I want to show you to look at your life. And it says, and Joseph, her husband, being a righteous man, not wanting to disgrace her, but planned to send her away secretly. Say secretly. Said, but when he had considered this, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared before him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child who has been conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost, and she will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Now all this took place to fulfill. Say, fear. See, you got to understand one thing. Joseph was in place to hear from God. Come on, it didn't make sense to his natural mind. You mean God want to use me? My daddy was a drunkard. My mama was a go-go dancer. But God wanted to use me to preach a gospel to a people. Come on here. You got to understand, my generation, my family line disqualified me. Come on here. I grew up in East Wind, and what they sold beer, liquor, they sold dope. Everything that I did, it disqualified me. But in your mind, she too young. You don't know her. That baby was right here. She ain't never but 2 or 3 years old. But the Holy Ghost was on her. You got to understand, God will prepare you, because he got a plan for your life. And see, you got to understand, it was fulfilled. It was prophesied that Jesus would come. How many prophecies have been spoken over your life? Come on here. The prophecy can't work unless you obey. Come on here. See, Joseph had to obey. Because if Joseph didn't obey, Jesus would have to pick somebody else. See, you're trying to make the prophecy line up according to your thinking. See, but the Bible said, lean not to your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge me, and I will direct your path. See, the angel said, nah, don't you divorce her. This is of God. She's going to give birth to a deliverer, a savior of the world, and you can't touch her until she have the baby. See, you trying to make stuff make sense to you. Don't you think that was strange to Joseph? You want me to take care of that woman? You want me to feed her? And this baby, I don't even know. I got to take care of somebody that ain't even mine. That didn't make sense to that man. But he understood that he had a reverential fear for the things of to Matthew 2. So when you jump to Matthew 2, let's look at verse 1 through 2. So you got to understand, say purpose. So when you look at chapter 2, verse 1, say, now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, come on here, in Bethlehem, and Herod the king, Magi from the east, arrived in Jerusalem saying, where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we saw his star in the east and have come to worship him. See, you got to understand that if somebody been bragging before you got here, somebody told your mama, come on here, you're going to give birth to a world changer. Come on here, you're going to give birth to somebody who's going to bring the bloodline, that's going to make the bloodline cleanse. Come on here, I can just hear God telling my mama, you're going to give birth to a bloodline. Somebody, a child that's going to cleanse the bloodline. We were praying for people. I was on the missionary board. I was on the usher board. I was on everything that I could be in the church. Because I don't think she understood who I was going to be. She just worked with it. Oh, my daughter do it. Oh, my daughter, I said, I don't want to do it. Oh, yes, she's going to do it. Oh, my child going to do it. See, that's the problem. We're giving our children too many options. And you got to understand it's the parent job to put them where they need to be. My mama didn't push me. Amen. What if she didn't take me to the nursing home? What if she didn't have me singing in the choir? She had me being an usher. She had me singing in the choir. She had me even on the exercise team. I mean, I was on everything. I said, my God, I had about like 5 or 6 different outfits for the church. Then she had me go teach the people, go pay your tithe. I had to learn how to pay my tithe. See, I learned all this as a child. So when I got up, when things got hard for me in my life, I always knew to pursue God because she always told me. See, there's a purpose for my life. Amen. See, somebody got to speak it over your life. And see, you got to understand when no word has been spoken over your life, you got to line up according to those words. Now let's jump to verse 7. Verse 7 say, then Herod secretly, he called the Magi and determined from the exact time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, go and search carefully for the child. And when you have found him, report to me so that I may come and worship him. Say a lie. So you got to understand he was telling a lie. Because you got to understand he was a king. And he said, oh my God, you think I'm going to let another king and take my place? So he said, he told the wise men, when you see this star and you see this baby, call me because I want to come and worship him. See, you got to understand, everybody don't want you to walk in what God got for you to walk in.
Come on.
It can be your loved one.
That's right.
It can be your spouse.
That's right.
It can be your children.
Amen.
It can be your prayer partner.
Amen.
They do not want you to walk in what God called for you to walk in because they understand. The Bible says that you got to count the cost. Come on here. You can't go to the Louis Vuitton talking about, I want to put it on layaway. Come on here. You can't talk to them about no layaway. Give me your clearance. They don't have it.
Right.
So when you look at verse